Hello, my name is Dr. Nitiraj, Oberoi. I'm a consultant orthopaedic surgeon at Dharamshila, Narayana Superspeciality Hospital at New Delhi. We notice in my practice now that there is a large number of people who come to us with shoulder problems. Let's talk about shoulder problems today. So what is a shoulder joint? A shoulder joint is not just what is visible here, but it also includes a bone at the back and a bone at the front. So a shoulder blade, a collarbone, and the shoulder joint, along with the joint of this whole structure with our chest, comprises the shoulder. So if you have a shoulder pain, we have to make sure where it's coming from. So shoulder pains can come either from in and around the shoulder or can get referred to the shoulder. So it can be referred from your tummy, from your heart, and from other parts of the body. A surgeon will try to look for all causes of shoulder pain before he comes to a conclusion. We must also understand that the spine forms a very important part. The spine forms a very integral part of the shoulder. Spine suspends the shoulder. So if we have a stoopy posture, it's going to represent in the form of pain at the back of the shoulder. If we have a pinched nerve in the neck, the pain gets referred to the shoulder. So the first thing we want to make sure is, how is our posture? Which brings us to the next big problem. The next big problem is our youth. School kids have bad postures. I see a lot of school children with pain around the back of the shoulder blade. And the problem essentially is correcting the posture. Then the other part of our youth, which is working on computers for long periods, are very prone to what is known as RSI or repetitive strain injury. These are ergonomic disasters. When they happen because of prolonged laptop and desktop usage, people come back with not only wrist and elbow pain, but also a lot of shoulder pain. What is the process? Correction involves correcting your posture and the way that your working bench has been organized. Now let's go down to understanding what happens if the problem is more severe. The doctor is now going to investigate. So amongst the newer tools besides the MRI and the X-ray, ultrasound is forming a big backbone in managing and diagnosing shoulder problems. So a musculoskeletal oncologist will do a dynamic study of your ultrasonic study of your shoulder, compare it to the opposite side, and try to understand when the shoulder moves, how do the soft tissues behave. We also use this tool for intervention. So if we can pinpoint where the problem is, we can use triangulation techniques and instill either medicines, platelet-rich plasma, or just use dry needling to relieve a lot of shoulder-based pain. Now, the next topic which comes up, which is important now because of a lot of high-velocity movement that people have on two-wheelers, we have a lot of shoulder fractures. And these shoulder fractures are not what we used to see 20 years back because they were low velocity. We get complex shoulder problems now. There is comminution or there is shattering of the bone and there is a lot of involvement of soft tissue. There have been newer technologies in the form of newer kinds of plates which have been designed to accommodate for these kind of fractures. And in those people who are elderly and get these kind of fractures, people or surgeons are usually now directly moving into operating by replacing the shoulder. So we find better results in early primary replacement of irretrievable shoulder injuries in the elderly than just putting it back. But recently, there has also been a lot of interest in conservative management of shoulder fractures. And so much so that there has been a new definition of shoulder patterns, injury patterns, which can be decided as velocity of two-wheelers is increasing, we have higher intensity injury to the body, including the shoulder. The kind of fractures we get now are not what we had 20 years back. Hence, we have newer plates, newer surgical techniques of putting together these rather complex and shattered fractures. But in the elderly people, where we also get these fractures, we are staying away from just putting plates on it. Now we do what is known as a primary joint replacement and we find better results with it. So if your surgeon suggests that go ahead and have your joint replaced because you've had a fracture, please do not be surprised. It is a good modality with good results. Very recently, we have started re-looking at our results that come out of surgery for fractures. And we noticed that there is now a defined subset of fractures which can be dealt with conservatively. We don't have to operate all shoulder fractures. So it's good to be informed as a patient and as a surgeon as to where is your fracture lying and what can we expect out of it. Now, if you move away from fractures on the shoulder, we come to keyhole surgeries. Shoulder has seen a great resurgence in keyhole surgery, and the indications are pain, impingement, instability. My shoulder keeps coming out. Every time I throw the ball, I feel my shoulder is going to come away. If I try to reach out to the back of my car and pick something up, I get a stabbing pain in my shoulder. These are conditions where we can actually use minimal invasive telescopic or arthroscopic surgery to fix the problem. And I'm happy to report that in the last 7 to 10 years, our results for these surgeries done endoscopically match those which are done through an open procedure, which means you get the surgery through small cuts, you go home the next day, and your rehabilitation period is cut down. This is a real positive development as far as shoulder surgery is concerned. Shoulder replacements. When I was training, we hardly had shoulder replacements. But as evolution happened and we started defining our indications for shoulder surgery, we came across the point that there is a large subset of people who get arthritis of the shoulder, especially rheumatoid arthritis of the shoulder, and we have to do reconstruction surgery or replacement surgery. So, of late, a great marvel of engineering which happened in the shoulder was developing what is known as a reverse shoulder. And reverse shoulder is now finding more and more takers, and its base and expansion, and there has been an expansion in the indication base of this surgery. So from trauma to tumors to soft tissue injuries to degeneration, everything finds favor in reverse shoulder replacement surgery. It produces good and reproducible results. The implants are getting easier to use from a surgical perspective, and hence they have better results. The rehabilitation for the shoulder has undergone a sea change as well, and we have specific programs as we understand the biomechanics of the shoulder better. We have redesigned our programs, and most surgical problems, most shoulder problems do not need intervention. Only a small handful of them need intervention. Most are managed through rehabilitation. Your surgeon should be able to understand the cause of your problem and hence be able to create a tailor-made program for your betterment.